And then came back again the following day to continue making the middle part of the dining table, since we started the project a bit late, so we couldn't finish on time. Once it was done making the middle part of the dining table, I covered the top part using the square boards which were cut in shape to cover the opening on the top. Once I was done making the middle part of the dining table, I went ahead to take the measurements of it so as to know where it will lie on the base of the dining table. After making the points, I went ahead and took the big ruler so as to join in the points to give me the correct measurement or the correct space where the middle part of the dining table will lie on the base. Once it was done, I went ahead and took the base and placed it on top of the middle part so as to make it easier to drill down the pivot holes and also to put in the screws. Once I was done putting in the screws, I went ahead and covered the base of the dining table. As you can see, did the same as I had made the base. I made some holes and also went ahead to add more screws so as to cover the bottom part of the dining table. Once we were done joining the middle part and also the bottom part of the dining table, we went ahead to make the top part of the dining table. Just the same way we did with the bottom part of the dining table, we aligned the boards together, used the staple gun to hold the boards together so as to make it easier to make the pivot holes and also to add the screws on the top part of the dining table. On the base part of the dining table, I went ahead to take the measurements of the middle part of the dining table where it will lie on the top part of the dining table. Once we were done, we went ahead and placed the top part of the dining table on the middle part of the dining table and had to make sure it lies well together. So the owner had to make sure the table fits in well and it's the right measurement for her dining chairs. Once we were done, we went ahead and make the pivot holes in which we'd be putting in the screws. So we had to make a lot of pivot holes so as to make sure the top part of the dining table holds well together on the middle part of the dining table. After we were done, we had to measure or to make sure the table is strong enough, so we had to lift it up a little bit to see if it holds the base and also the middle part well together. After that, we went ahead and covered the top part of the dining table using more screws so as to make sure the top part holds well together. She decided her table to be painted black, so we had to get a profession to do that. After the table was dry, we went ahead and added these mirror tiles, which will be covering the side part of the dining table. The mirror tiles measure 7.5 centimeters by 7.5, so they're perfect for this project. So we'll be adding them, as you can see, using this silicone glue that I normally use in most of my projects, and also I'll be adding hot glue so as to make sure the mirror sticks well and faster. I had to use a pair of scissors to cut in the mirror tiles. It's easier doing this because it will make it easier to stick them well, unlike sticking one mirror at a time. So I had to cut them in line so as to stick them while they are 4 pieces. I went ahead and added some silicone glue on the top part of the dining table whereby the bigger glass will lie on top. So she had to use a black glass on this project. She didn't need a mirror, so she had to use a black glass. dining table. I then went ahead to remove the protective film of the mirror tiles, and then we had to turn the table so that you guys can see how this dining table has turned out. So this is just the beginning of her dining makeover. So she had to start with the dining table, then after that she'll go ahead and make the chairs for her dining. So stay tuned so as to see the final project of her dining makeover, but meanwhile I'll just show you the project that we did for the dining table. Once it was done, we went ahead to clean down the dining table using this glass cleaner. So we had to scrub off the mirror tiles well so as to make sure they shine well properly, and also to remove the excess glue which is always on top of the mirror tiles due to the coverage. And finally guys, after cleaning down the mirrored dining table, this is the end look of a beautiful dining table. Let me know in the comment section what you think about this beautiful dining table we've just made with my beautiful friend Miss Sweet. For those who are back to my channel, thank you so much guys for your love and support, and those who are new, please remember to subscribe and also click on the notification bell so as to get notified whenever I post a new video. Thank you so much guys for your support, and to anyone who has joined my channel today, please feel free to come back again. Thank you so much. Bye bye. See you next time for a new video.